Dès 1963, le comité international répondait à l'appel au secours des populations du Yémen tout entier. C'est l'histoire merveilleuse et effrayante à la fois de quelques hommes qui ont quitté leur travail et leur pays pour se mettre au service du comité international. Notre histoire commence à Jeddah. C'est là que l'équipe médicale du CICR prendra le Dakota qui va l'amener jusqu'à l'île de Najran, situé aux confins de l'Arabie Saoudite et du Yémen.
1964, a senior medical student at Guy's on the way to being qualified. My colleague and I from our flat, David Rhodes, saw an advert in the BMJ looking for doctors to work for the Red Cross in the Yemen. He thought, well, this sounds like a nice warm place. I think we might try that. We got to Najran. We landed on a simple airstrip, which was basically just a hardened sand runway with some oil drums at one end and oil drums at the other, and that was the airport.
Dearest Jane, I've received your letter yesterday. Believe me, 3 weeks without hearing from you was quite a strain. We've just seen a little baby with acute pneumonia, so thin and pathetic. 6 hours away, the war goes on. We see only the result of war here. Prince Mohammed Ibn Hussein has sent a request for some doctors to go to the front, to treat people before they are sent here, and if possible, we three hope to go.
David looked after the medical patients, and I looked after those who'd been wounded in the war.
We have heard a lot of shooting today, and we saw pools of smoke. It isn't near, but it makes more patients. The soldiers are often only 12 to 14 years old, and on a poor diet, so they go down with all sorts of illnesses very quickly. Due to the fighting and bombing nearby, lots of casualties have been arriving, and Fred and I work long hours operating on them. Yesterday, a soldier came in after a journey of 4 days, minus his right hand and left thumb. Darling, war is such a stupid thing, and I am quite fed up with it, seeing these young men torn and blown to pieces.
Yeah, David was a great letter writer. He used to send a lot about his medical patients, and a lot of the photographs, which are David's, show patients with great big livers and great big spleens and generally ill.
Not long now. I simply can't wait, but the time will go ever so quickly since tomorrow night we leave. It's a 2-day journey, done mostly at night with the lights off on the truck and then ending up with a stiff climb with camels loaded with medical supplies, up the mountain and then down again.